Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the five best 5.0 Coyote Mustang GT engine upgrades. One quick note before we jump into the actual five mods that we're going to be discussing in this video. The Coyote's been around since 2011, so it's currently on its third generation. And when it comes to mods and upgrading the 5.0 Coyote, the newer generations are a little bit more capable than the previous generations. So the Gen 3 is going to be more capable than the Gen 2, and the Gen 2 is going to be a little bit more capable than the Gen 1. But we'll circle back to that point in the summary towards the end of the video, talk about what that means for all these mods and what ballpark these upgrades will put the 5.0 Coyote in, depending on which generation engine you have or that you're looking at. So jumping right into the best mods for the 5.0 Coyote and the Mustang GT, number one, we have a tune. And a tune on naturally aspirated cars isn't going to provide massive power gains like it will on a turbo or supercharged engine. But a tune is still a great starting point for the 5.0 Coyote and also for a lot of other cars and engines. On the 5.0 Coyote, you can expect to pick up about 10 to 20 horsepower, depending on which tuning route you go. So already decent power gains right off the bat. And on top of that, a tune is really the foundation for building a more powerful 5.0 Coyote and allows you to get the most out of additional modifications. So the best gains for 5.0 Coyote tuning will actually come from custom tuning. And custom tuning will really just help dial things into your specific car and your specific setup. So if you do want to go the custom tuning route, keep in mind that is going to add some extra costs, and tweaks and changes will be required if you end up adding more modifications after that. So maybe something to hold off on if you know you just want to start with a tune, just get an off-the-shelf tune, especially if you're planning on adding additional mods in the near future. Maybe hold off on the custom tuning just so you don't have to keep going back and spending additional money on more iterations of the tune. Our number two best mod on the list here actually ties into tuning, and that is running E85 or ethanol in the Mustang GT. And so E85 tuning can pick up generally anywhere from about 30 to 50 horsepower on the high end, especially for those Gen 3s with the port and direct fuel injection and the 12.0:1 compression ratio. Those engines respond extremely well to E85. So just with E85 tuning, you could see power gains on the high end of that range coming in near 50 wheel horsepower. So very impressive gains for just throwing some E85 in there. A lot of that comes down to E85 or ethanol fueling has much better knock suppression, which allows your tuner to increase the ignition timing quite a bit, advance the timing quite a bit, which is where a lot of those additional power gains come from. And ultimately, E85 is just a lot safer and healthier for the engine. And if you're ever planning to move into bigger mods like forced induction, E85 is great to have, because when you start throwing even more power at the car and adding forced induction, the difference between a 93 octane tune and an E85 tune could be even in the ballpark of 75 to 100 plus wheel horsepower just from moving to E85. So definitely a great mod for the 5.0 Coyote. One thing to keep in mind is E85 does require quite a bit more fuel flow, so not a huge issue with modest modifications on the third gen engine with the dual fueling setup, but on the Gen 1 and Gen 2 engines, you'll likely end up needing a fuel injector upgrade, and you might even consider a fuel pump. It might not be necessary, but always a good safety to add in there just to ensure you're not leaning out and you actually have the proper equipment to flow that extra demanding fuel requirements from E85. So fuel injectors and a fuel pump, both great upgrades if you do want to convert to full E85. Moving on to number three on the list here, we have a cold air intake, and this is something that isn't one of the biggest power mods for the 5.0 Coyote. However, the real benefit of an intake is it's such a cheap and simple upgrade. And on the Coyote, it can add anywhere from about 5 to 10 horsepower, especially when you start throwing more and more mods at the Mustang. You'll have more demanding airflow requirements, so you can start to see power gains on the higher end when you start throwing additional mods at the car. So it's a great addition if you're looking to just get started modding your 5.0 Mustang. Comboing the intake with a tune is a great starting point for the Mustang GT. Moving on to number four on the list, we have long tube headers. And those are one of the best power mods for the 5.0 Coyote, at least if you're looking to stay naturally aspirated. Long tube headers can show power gains of about 20 to 30 wheel horsepower, so very impressive power gains. The downside with headers is they can be a little pricey and install can be complicated, so if you're not DIYing the project and you end up at a shop, you can expect to pay probably another $500 or so in installation for that. So it makes it a little bit of a pricey upgrade for the Mustang 5.0 Coyote. But again, 20 to 30 wheel horsepower, that's a lot on a naturally aspirated engine, not power gains that you're gonna see from just any mod out there. Definitely a great modification, great upgrade all around. One thing to bring up with long tube headers is you'll run into two primary options since that will remove the OEM catalytic converters. So you'll see either catless options or high flow catted options. Of course, the high flow catted options are gonna have a better chance of passing any form of actual emissions testing or visual inspections. Since the catalytic converters are in place, you shouldn't have any issues with that. Although high flow cats can still be considered illegal since it is tampering with the OEM exhaust system. And catless obviously is going to be a big issue, passing emissions and even visual inspections, because the lack of catalytic converters will be an instant fail in most cases. A couple downsides to those long tube headers are expensive and brings emissions and visual inspections into question. But again, for 20 to 30 wheel horsepower, it's really hard to beat those power gains for what this mod is. Moving on to number 5 on the list here, we have a cat-back or axle-back exhaust upgrade. Of course, on the 5.0 Coyote V8, any exhaust upgrade is gonna sound awesome, especially if you pick the right setup or the right sound that suits you best. However, an exhaust system is likely only going to pick up about 3 to 5 horsepower, and that might even be a little bit on the optimistic side. You might see no gains at all with an exhaust system. So we're mostly throwing this on here if you want that awesome sounding Coyote, then exhaust upgrades are a great choice. But if you're really just chasing power, then probably skip the exhaust upgrades, especially for the cost of some exhaust systems where you could be looking at $1,000, $1,500, even $2,000 or more to upgrade the exhaust. There are better places to put that money if really your end goal is just to make more power and not necessarily go after those sounds. And that's especially true if you're already going with the long tube headers. Those can add some great sounds, and adding a full exhaust system after doing the long tube headers could make things extremely loud and maybe a little uncomfortable for some. So something to keep in mind, but an exhaust system, certainly a popular and excellent upgrade for the 5.0 Coyote. If performance is the end goal, probably look to spend that money somewhere else, like an intake manifold, especially on the first and second gen engines. The third gen Coyote has a great flowing intake manifold, so you probably won't see great benefits from upgrading that on the third gen engines. But on the first and second gen, you can see 10, even 20 horsepower from upgrading that intake manifold. So great place to spend the money if you're not looking for sounds and don't want an exhaust system on the Coyote. That wraps up our 5 best mods for the Mustang GT. As a couple final notes here for this video, we mentioned the differences between the first, second, and third gen a little bit. So what does that all mean in terms of these modifications and how much power the Coyote can make? So the first gen engines with these mods that we discussed, you can expect to end up in the low 400 wheel horsepower ballpark, somewhere around 400 to 410 wheel horsepower. More is certainly possible if you throw on additional mods like camshaft, intake manifold we just discussed towards the end. Possible to get a little bit more, but with the main 5 mods we discussed, tune, E85 intake, long tube headers, and an exhaust system, about 400 wheel horsepower is a good number to expect from those mods. On the second gen engine, you can expect to see about 440, maybe 450 wheel horsepower. And then on the newest 2018 plus third gen engines, those have a pretty easy time getting to 500 wheel horsepower. Seeing anywhere from about 490 to 520 wheel horsepower with these mods on the third gen. Obviously great power gains, great end result for that third gen engine. Anyway, that said, that wraps up our video for the 5 best Mustang GT engine upgrades. If you guys liked the video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content on the 5.0 Coyote. Thanks, guys.